Hello everyone, myself Ketan Bhavsa, Assistant Professor in LG Engineering College, Ahmedabad. In today's session in Embedded System, we discuss about digital camera. See, as you already know in previous session, we already discussed, there are a number of applications right now, yeah? Which is a part of Embedded System, and as you already discussed, from starting from the day, means from morning to the night, we are using number of embedded devices and we use in daily routine. And camera is one of the best examples that already we are dealing, because as you already know, in 21st century, people are using camera in wide application, and because of that reason, number of people choose a smartphone based on the camera. Right? So camera is playing a main role. So there are a number of applications in there which describe what exactly embedded system is, but right now we are focusing on the digital camera. Now what exactly the camera contains, we are talking about the component of a specific digital camera. Which type of a component that they are going to use? So as you can see from the screen, LCD enter screen for the frame view, keys, CCD, ADC, ASIP, CCD, DSP, microcontroller, timer, DAC, embedded software, microcontroller, printer, computer, serial port, USB port, basically Bluetooth connectivity, DAC, and a LCD and the touchscreen frame view. So basically these are the main component, or we can say the main part of a specific camera, right? So now what exactly the use of LCD? So if you are capturing some object, if you are capturing some type of image, so basically LCD is required for the presentation point of view. Without LCD you cannot see the, what exactly image is. After capturing the image, what we see, what our image looks. So in, we definitely see that particular image inside a screen. It can be a touch screen or it can be a only normal screen. It based on the which type of the camera that you gonna use, it based on the range type of camera. If you are to go with the high costlier camera, then they are giving you the screen mechanism. CCD, the charge coupled device. ADC. The ADC is generally used to convert the analog data into digital format, because the world is generally analog, right? So when you capture the frame, it converts that particular data into the digital format. Microcontroller, timers, and DAC. Microcontroller and timer is generally used specifically to operate on monitoring, or you can say that the control, the task control, the frame rate control, a specific configuration base. Similarly, the DSP processor is also working in that particular manner. If you want to go with a high resolution camera, if you go with like a portrait mode, if you go with some DSLR effect. So this particular type of the CCD DSPs play a main role on the charge coupled device. It is used to, you know, monitor the frame. When you try to zoom it, fine. So it will not go outside the frame. Your new images look better, and for that we use this type of the concept. Basically the software is there. Without software you cannot operate or monitor it or control or any type of the images. Similarly the flash memory is there for the storing the data. Right now camera is really came with different types of protocol like Bluetooth support, USB, serial communication, that you can directly connect with the printer and take a print. You are directly connected with your smartphone based on the Bluetooth based concept, and this design is old. Right now we can see the Wi-Fi based camera, and also you can see that a GSM based camera is also available in the market that you can operate, monitor and control from anywhere. So basically these different types of devices is there, which is really used, you know, to make your image, make your object much more clear vision for the user. So you can see the serial port is there, USB port is there, Bluetooth is there, To do this, we use for provide the connectivity from transmit the data from source to destination via the smartphone. Printers similarly work at the same manner. Fine, if you want to take a print of some specific data and the computer. So basically, these are the example of digital camera, right? So there are a number of examples that I already told you, but right now we are focusing on this particular example because which one is very popular right nowadays. Now talking about the components of camera. Now we go into the depth like light, flash and display device driver. So how you can set the focus based on the light, based on the night vision, the light will automatically turn on. The flash intensity based on the focus area. Then these are different types of drivers that definitely we gonna use. CCD signal processor task for processing the specific task which is going on. Pixel co-processing task will set the resolution of each and every pixel when you use a zooming effect. JPEG coder or decoder is used to compress your file, right? You capture the image and definitely that particular image stored in some specific space, okay? And that particular space is, if it takes a large number of spaces, then you capture a minimum image, right? So here the JPEG is joint picture action group. That particular group is really used to compress your data. So basically compress and decompress. Compress is really used to save the data, and when you have to reopen it, then again it will be decoded. LCD for display visual, Bluetooth for the connectivity, USB same for the connectivity, that you can directly connect with your printer, you can directly connect with your computer, right? So these are the device drivers and main component tasks of the digital camera. Now we already discussed what exactly the digital camera is. Now we go ahead and we discuss about the software in high level programming. See, basically, as you already know, when you're talking about the software, right, when you're talking about the software portion, then software is playing a main role. In terms of the software, you write the program in C language. That particular programming is converted into some machine language file. Then the linker is generally provide the connectivity with the available or existing resources, or we can say that available or existing programs. Then we connect with the library and then we execute the task. So basically, software level programming, when we're talking about the high level programming, then we have to write down the code. We have to compile it, it is okay or not. Then machine code, we have to convert it to object oriented file, and for that we have to link it. Suppose you are using the math file, suppose you are using some other Conio file, then it will be connected with the linker or with the library and convert it to the machine format, and then finally it will execute in a specific application, and then we have to store it in a memory. So basically, this one is an example of what exactly programming is. How you can program any embedded device, any microcontroller. These are the flow of writing the program. Before that, we discuss about the example of a digital camera, which is one of the main example. We can say that in current scenario, current generally you can say that the situation or current trends is going on in the camera side. So I'll just give you an example which is related to the camera, which is an embedded system. After that we move over to the next topic and we discuss about the programming in the software. So we discuss about the high level programming. In high level programming we have to follow the these strategies. Now programming model and software design. So there are the different types of model, like sequential programming model means one after another task will be going on. Object oriented programming like C language, C++. Control and data flow graph generally represent the graphical representations. FSM, that it is only used a finite state machine diagram to provide a parallel computing mechanism. And similarly, the multi-thread models means you have to connect or configure with the different types of models. So here we discuss about the programming model and we discuss about the different types of model which is available in the market. And it is a type of a programming that you have to write down in the software. It can be a AMCU accelerated software, it can be Arduino IDE, it can be AVR Studio, it can be a K programming, so it can be any type. Based on your application, there are different types of software modules. You just go with that one. If you go with the data program, then definitely you have to go with the Max or VX VR software, which is going on in the market for the robotics point of view. Similarly, if you go with the multi-thread model, then it can be configured with the multiple programming which is related to the RTU-based Linux concept. Okay, so here we discuss about the programming models in the software design. So I hope that you are getting the idea of what exactly I am trying to do. I give you an example of embedded system, which is a part of a digital camera. I mean, digital camera is one of the most important example or it's a part of embedded system that we discuss. After that, we discuss about the software models and also how exactly software is after writing the programming. You write down the code, but what exactly going on inside the software that it will be compiling. After compilation, that it will be linked with the existing file figures or you can see the headers. If it will match with that type of the header, then it will be executed as. Okay? So basically, we are working on this type of the method. So if you have any doubt which is related to a specific type of or software related model doubt, or if you have any doubt in the digital camera example, so you can feel free to contact me. So still if you have any doubt, you can ask me. So thank you for watching.